Hi there, everyone. Just a quick announcement and then just a brief thought. Firstly, the quick announcement. Tomorrow morning, Easter Sunday, we'll broadcast our sermon from our YouTube channel. So on Facebook and on WhatsApp, we'll send those links. And at about 10 a.m., please get the family together, sing a few choruses, spend some time in prayer, and then listen to the message that will be proclaimed. We'll look at the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And we'll look at the resurrection through the tomb of Jesus, and we'll be guided by these three points: the borrowed tomb of Jesus, the guarded tomb of Jesus, and then, of course, to our great delight and joy, the empty tomb of Jesus. And so I look forward to preach God's word to you tomorrow morning, and so do tune in to our YouTube channel at about 10 a.m. And then just a brief thought. It's Saturday today. On Friday, we celebrated the crucifixion of Jesus, for what it means for us. And tomorrow, Easter Sunday, we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus. However, not many know what we must make of the Saturday. It has traditionally been called Holy Saturday. And though there are many theological pitfalls to avoid when we think about Holy Saturday, there are many theological truths to glean from Holy Saturday. And I thought one is very relevant for our time that we are living in, for this COVID-19 pandemic time that we are living in which many are dying, in which we see many loved ones and those who know the Lord around the world succumbing to this virus. I think it's helpful to think about Holy Saturday. Holy Saturday is a day and it's a time in which Jesus remained in a state of death. Mm-hmm. Jesus didn't die on the cross on the Friday and then immediately was raised from the dead. He didn't die on the cross and then immediately came to. No, he died on the cross on the Friday and then he remained and continued in a state of death. He tasted death for us. In fact, the Westminster Confession of Faith Large Catechism writes and he says, Christ's humiliation after his death consisted in his being buried and continuing in the state of death under the power of death till the third day. Dear friends, Jesus Christ, fully God, fully man, truly God, truly man, as a true man, he experienced and tasted death, not merely tasted it, but he remained in a state of death until he was raised from the dead. As we think of our deaths and as we think of loved ones in the Lord who died and their deaths, I think we can be comforted to know that our Savior has been there. We can be comforted to know that he's tasted that. We can be comforted to know that he has remained in a state we are all heading towards. But not only did he remain there, he defeated death. He conquered death. He stood and he stood up victoriously from the dead, and he was resurrected. And so in the words of Jaya Packer, we can take great comfort from the death of Jesus Christ. Packer writes and he says, what makes Jesus' entry into Hades important for us is simply the fact that now we can face death knowing that when it comes, we shall not find ourselves alone. He has been there before us and he will see us through. And so may the Lord bless you as you think of Holy Saturday, as you think of Jesus remaining in that state of death, and as you think of your own death possibly, or even the deaths of loved ones who died in the Lord. Know this, that our Savior has been there. Not only has he been there, he has defeated death, stood up from the dead. He's been raised to life gloriously, and so too we will be raised to life gloriously. In the words of John, we know not what we will be, but when we see him, we will be like him. The Lord bless you.